fabric on this vintage cardigan. It's super cool, but I am not loving the length of it. So I would like to hem it so it's up towards my waist so I can wear it with all my high-waisted things and get a better proportion for me because I'm so short. Today I'm gonna take this long sweater and I'm gonna turn it into a crop sweater. It's gonna look so much better when I'm finished with it. So make sure you follow along and learn how to crop your cardigan. If you complete this project, make sure you DM me on Instagram at SewAnastasia or just hashtag all your photos SewAnastasia. I can't wait to see your finished projects. So if you send them over and tag me, there's a good chance I'll post them on my page. If you're not already a subscriber to SewAnastasia, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so that way you know when all the new videos come out. Also, I'm doing this really cool thing right now called virtual sewing lessons. So you can work on your project in your studio and I'm gonna help you from my studio. So if you're interested in virtual sewing lessons, go ahead and check out the link that's listed down below. Supplies for this project are super simple. You're going to need your pins, you're going to need your matching thread, you're also going to need some chalk and a ruler. But don't forget your scissors. And last but not least, you're also going to need a sewing machine. The first step is going to be trying on the cardigan and determining how short you want to make it. So let's go ahead, try it on, and figure it out. Grab your pins because we are going to fold up the sweater and pin it as short as we would like. So I have mine folded up here to where I think it is a good height on me. And I'm gonna go ahead and just stick a pin in it just to keep it in place. So go ahead and stick a couple pins in it. And we don't have to go all the way around. We really just need to mark half of it because we're gonna take in an even amount all the way around the sweater, front and back. Next, grab your ruler and we are going to measure the amount that we have folded and pinned. I have the ruler laid on the folded up piece of fabric with the pins in it and it's telling me I have 5.5 inches of fold. So I want my shirt to be 5.5 inches shorter. So what I need to do is actually take off 5 inches because I'm gonna leave a half inch for a hem. Next, we're gonna go ahead and unpin our hem and we're gonna measure 5 inches up from the hem and put a chalk mark. So that way we have a cutting line and we can cut off all the extra fabric at the hem. And we're gonna do this all the way around the sweater. So I'm chalking on the inside of the sweater and I'm measuring up 5 inches from the hem of the sweater. And I'm gonna go ahead and put a chalk line. Make sure when you're chalking, you've picked a measurement that's in between buttonholes because you don't want to hem straight into a buttonhole. Might look a little funny. So let's go ahead and move down and mark again. And you're gonna do this all the way around the hem of your sweater. This is gonna give us a nice even hem line. Grab your scissors and we're gonna go ahead and cut on that chalk line that we just created. Let's go ahead and follow this chalk line. You can cut right through the seam. Now that we've cut the bottom of our sweater off, we're gonna have this raw edge and we don't want our sweater to fall apart on us. That would be awful. So I'm gonna go over to the serger and I'm gonna serge the hem so that way the fibers stay together. And then we're gonna go over to the regular sewing machine and put a blind hem at the bottom of this cardigan. If you don't have a serger, no worries. You can totally use a wide zigzag stitch or an overcasting stitch for this step. Now that we're at the serger, it's time to finish the raw edge on the sweater. So let's serge it up. So you can see the serger is holding together the edge of this sweater. So before it was really raw and it was kind of falling apart. So now we've secured it together, which is really important so our sweater doesn't fall apart. Now that we have the hem serged, grab your pins and we are gonna pin up the hem at a half inch. So fold it up a half inch and go ahead and put a pin in it vertically. Go ahead and do that on the entire hem. Now that we have the hem all pinned, let's go over to the sewing machine and hem it up. Today I'm gonna be using the Husqvarna Viking Designer Epic 2. You can use any sewing machine that has a blind stitch on it. So for this sewing machine blind hem stitch, you're gonna use the D foot. So the D foot looks like this. If you need help understanding what a blind hem is, make sure you check out my other video that's all about how to create a blind hem. The link will be down below in the description and it'll also pop up here on a card for you. Make sure you either backstitch or fix at the beginning so that way your stitch doesn't fall apart. Now the very front might be a little difficult because the binding on the front of the cardigan could be thicker than the rest of the cardigan, so just be careful. So your blind hem stitch is going to sew straight on the right and then it's going to come over to the left to take one of the fibers. And this is making it blind. Again, if you need more reference on the blind hem, make sure you check out my other video on blind hems. So notice I'm folding that half inch under and I'm stitching straight where that serge is. Careful when you get to the side seam, go slow. It's gonna be extra bulky, push it down a bit. Again, when we get to the end where this binding is on the front and where the buttonhole is, it's gonna be really thick. So be really careful and go slow so you don't break your needle. Backstitch at the end. Or fix and then cut. Voila, we are finished. We hemmed the sweater and it looks awesome. So I want you to check out the blind hem that we created on this up close. So the inside looks beautiful. So you've got our serge stitch there. And then on the outside, there's no stitch. It's completely blind. How awesome. I'm super excited about how this sweater turned out. It's time to add it to my fall wardrobe. This will look great with denim, over a skirt or a dress. Now it's time to figure out how to style it. Don't forget this awesome technique of hemming a cardigan when you're out thrifting next time. So when you see that cardigan that's way too long and outdated, don't worry, snag it up because you can hem it. Thanks so much for watching Sew Anastasia today. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below and I'll get back with you as soon as I can. As always, make sure you follow me on social media at Sew Anastasia on Instagram and Facebook and all those other fabulous social media sites. And don't forget, I wanna see your finished project. So make sure you DM me photos or tag me at Sew Anastasia so I can share with everybody else your awesome projects. Also, don't forget, I have virtual sewing classes and in-person sewing classes if you're in Chicago. So information about all of that is also going to be down below. Hop on over to Patreon and check out all the awesome ways you can help support and grow Sew Anastasia. If you love this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up or an applause. And if you're not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you know when all the new videos come out. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.